enemy launched an advanced UAV. We're exposed.
Woohoo!
Let's have fun!
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.
Mission failed. We'll get him next time.
Welcome. Welcome to Chris Pollard Live, which is tonight broadcasted live from the dying wishes of Boris Yeltsin. Rest in peace, head, shoulders, whatever. Chris Pollard Live tonight would not be possible at all without the gracious funding from our sponsors, which include Paul Hazelnut's Biscuits for Men, the Water Retention Prevention Convention, and David Attenborough's new BBC One series, What to Do When You've Eaten a Pritt Stick. We're also sponsored tonight by Silic Bang Bros, the UK's most illicit kitchen cleaner. On the day where Britain's sheep farmers declared they had had enough with the ongoing closure of Debenhams, and Emma Bunton revealed her new comeback single, Sicked Up In My Mouth And Swallowed It. However, in other words, you're sure about that. Tonight's show, this is what's happening.
On tonight's program.
On tonight's show, I will be tenderly relieving you by having a look at some of the world records that have been broken and just given a light shuffle in World Record Weekly. We will have an elegant dance past the community corkboard before winding up on Did You Know Boulevard, all of which we recommend tonight pairing with a well-matured bottle of Malbec, an earthy Stilton, possibly atop a Hovis biscuit, and lashings of thick beef gravy. But now here's this. To Chris Pollard Live, folks. Before the break, you heard Vampire Blues by Neil Young, and after the break, you've just heard Where's Your Head At by Basement Jacks. Another old school. Oh, God, didn't it just have you jumping in your chair? Sorry if you do not have the ability to jump for whatever reason. Very offensive of me. But we press forward, as we always do, with some sports. With some sports. Tonight, your condensed sport headlines. Tiger Woods won, Macclesfield Town lost. Lucy Obtuse 9, Karen Manifesto 2. England crashed out, while South Korea surged forward. And a hand-picked panel of judges selected Little Wilbury of Bridlington Bay to be the world's fastest pet slug. Horse riding, badminton, indoor squash. Archery, rowing, sports for the posh. And finally, Hopely Springtaps sealed the deal with a stunning bicycle kick in the 92nd minute, advancing the Carolina Puddle Drinkers to the quarterfinals of the Neil Diamond Charity Shield. That's literally all I've got.
You fans can stick it, brother!
What's up? You're listening to World Record Weekly on Chris Pollard Live.
Welcome back to the show, guys. There was High Pressure Days by The Unit. Something a bit more recent for you. Yeah, something you've probably not heard before, eh? Did you think to that? Probably didn't like it. But yes, here we are listening to World Record Weekly. Well, I'm not listening to it, I'm conducting it. But thank you for listening to it, where we cast an eye over some of those astonishing attempts that have been made all over the world in the field of world records in the last 7 days. And those also we can expect in the near future. First of all, there were sad scenes today as Britain's own Toby Liftings failed to claim the world record for world's cleanest crime scene. The plucky young British murderer looked to be doing everything right up until the point where one of his onion rings fell out of his pocket, tying him by DNA to the homicide, where he now awaits a trial date. In more uplifting news, The world record for highest human chin was smashed late into last week after a monumental overnight surge. An overnight surge from Brazilian contortionist Alejandro Gaga. His already sizeable chin grew an impressive 6 meters overnight, and he is being stored in a nearby warehouse for further Guinness verification, along with awaiting the construction of a new massive face mask for outdoor socializing. Very sensible. Also on World Record Weekly this week, the city of Birmingham itself entered the books for the first time after breaking the record for the world's most acceptable place to publicly urinate. The mayoress was overwhelmed with pride as she received the award. With the record changing hands from sort of behind this Mecca Bingo in Aldershot somewhere. And finally, the record for world's most dangerous hairstyle has finally changed hands, leaving pop sensation Gareth Gates for the first time since his rise to notoriety even on Pop Idol. The record, which has been a long sought after one by many, was finally captured by an Australian museum guide with several hedgehogs glued to his head. That's all the records we've got for World Record Weekly here this weekly on World Record Weekly. I'll see you next weekly for World Record Weekly. How did that go? All right. Yeah, I think it was quite a good one. Yeah.
You're on air because that's Chris Pollard Live. It's a bit like playing backgammon in the garden in the naked and your neighbour catches you watching and they're watching and seeing your scrotum.
Going, welcome back to the show, guys. That was me with a bogey in my throat, but before that there was Salt, spelled s-a-u-l-t, with West Brom with I Just Want to Dance, a toe tapper that was really West Brom that was released last year, and I just thought I'd switch the West Brom I thought I'd switch the vibe up just to give the show a bit more of an energetic feel. Still to come on tonight's programme, we have got a Christmas stocking come 9 months early, filled to the brim with top music and content for you, including, but not limited to, The Soul Cellar with Alex Sweeney, and Hot and Cool with Chris Coxon. And if you want to get in touch tonight, West Brom, by all means, you are more than welcome to do so. West Brom, please text studio plus your message to 88802. West Brom, or you can tweet at Durham On Air on Twitter, or you can email studio at durhamonair.com, and there's plenty of time to get your shout outs out. But when we return after this next song, we will be playing Connection Section. I hope it doesn't give you a West Brom. Well, what an abrupt way to end that song. Thanks, Tame Impala.
The Connection Section.
Oh. There was Elephant by Tame Impala, by the way. But it's time to dim those dimmer switches. Time to put that hot meat in the slow cooker. Because it's time for Connection Section, where you've been getting in touch all week with your listings, wanting some hot local action, like it says just by the side of the video you're watching on your favourite website when no one's watching. First of all, our first listing, strapping 6 foot tall ice cream man wants to find a 99 for his flake, along with covering you in his bits and juice. I enjoy strolling in the Cotswolds and stealing in cost cutters. Get in touch now if you are between the ages of 51 and 53, but not including 51 or 53. 52 then is what you mean by that. Ice Cream Man. Next up, Lonely Buxom Brunette 64 can go on longer than Doddy at the Palladium, looking ideally for a secondary school history teacher called Tarquin. Must have keen interest on fine wines, high fives, spreadable cheeses and unspreadable diseases. Next up, I've had enough of feeling alone in this world, writes self-confessed cat killer Adam, 38, from Stanhope. Must own car, Sky Digital and ongoing supply of cats, along with somewhere for my mum to sleep at night. Good luck there with that one, Adam. Next up, stunning and flexible 8-foot-tall paediatrician's assistant seeks Michael Jackson impersonator at the nearest available opportunity. Age is not an issue, nor is shoe size. Let's transform the media landscape, she adds. And she's also attached to this submission a photo of a marriage pipe, a potato. So you worked that one out there, fellas. Could be sexual. And finally, the last listing we've got tonight. Why did Bobby George lookalike, aged 19, seeks anyone with false teeth for devious reasons? I have big arms and I'm not scared of going in the lift anymore. Please, 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 I cannot stress enough, no teeth. Well, they're all the listings that we've got. If you can satisfy any of those lustuous, these, if you can help any of these horny people, now is the time to do so, people. County Durham, get in touch. At Durham on Air, we're here till 9 o'clock. Let's make some magic happen. Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. There was Icky Thump by the White Stripes, and we are sub an hour to go before handing over to the Soul Cellar, and there's still plenty of time to let us know what your favourite cut of meat is. It's time that we head over to the Community Cork Board.
The County Durham Community Cork Board.
Oh, that's nice. Four entries tonight on the Community Cork Board. Sorry, I just wanted to wait for that beautiful sort of electric violin to come in there. Welcome to your virtual audio parish council Community Cork Board. Place your post-its all over my body. Prick me with pins. Oh, draw blood, will you? First of all tonight, the first service we have... Right, I'm just going to take a little sip of my Fanta Orange. I'm going to come back to this in 5 seconds. Our first service tonight, Billy Pickett Lines, Guy Fawkes for Hire Service. Hire me personally every November 5th to make your Guy Fawkes night one to remember. My service comes with super realistic screaming sounds and promises to be the highlight of the occasion until the fire engine shows up. Nobody has yet enlisted my service, so get in quick before the inevitable rush. £4,000 per evening. Next up, put yourselves in the shoes of your favourite blind musician with Paul Cragg's Express Eye Poking Service. £3.50 an eye. Musical instruments not included. Next up, call Kraft Collins Clandestine Food Harvesting Service. 25-year expertise in pea-pulling, apple-scragging and strawberry theft. £50 per night. Please bring your own bags, head torch and fast-running shoes. And finally tonight on the Community Cork Board, Antonio Bruschetta's Multi-Story Car Park Adventures. Join me and my team of experts as we visit the car park of your choice and enjoy every single level while we run through the history of your favourite car park, share anecdotes with security staff and finish with a signature turkey and melon sandwich. Car park must be multi-story. No exceptions. £75 plus expenses and travel for all members of the expert panel. That's all we've got on the Community Cork Board. If you would like to enlist any of those services, please get in touch. studio@durhamonair.com is the email, and I'm around till 9 o'clock to fulfil your every last desire. Don't think like that, though. is Todd Rundgren with I Saw the Light. Oh, did you, Todd? Good for you.
You're currently listening to Chris Pollard Live. Now available as a low-calorie spread.
Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. Folks, you've just heard the unreal Joni Mitchell with The Jungle Line. And before that, I Saw the Light by Todd Rundgren. Hope you're doing well wherever you're listening. It's quite a cold, chilly evening. And I hope you're nice and warm wherever you are. I'm killing time because I'm just waiting to compile my last fact for Did You Know? That was the wrong one. Let's try that one again. Did you know? Did you know? Did you know that the Z in the name of hit rapper Jay-Z stands for zoologist? You know, always good to have a job to fall back on if the rapping thing doesn't work out.
Did you know?
Did you know? Did you know? That Robert Peston, or Bobby Pesto to his inner circle, refuses to eat his dinner unless it has been first glazed with the tears of a monkey.
Did you know?
Did you know? After working on the most recent Toy Story film, Tom Hanks now spends his Sunday afternoons defacing council property for a laugh.
Did you know?
Thug. Did you know? Did you know? Did you know that horseradish sauce was invented as a way of keeping Jack Nicholson off the sausage rolls on the set of A Few Good Men?
Did you know?
Did you know that Angus Dayton is blatantly patient?
Did you know?
Did you know? The character of Hannibal Lecter was based loosely on Royal Family star Ricky Tomlinson after he'd had a few pints of Guinness and some Haribo Star Mix.
Did you know? Did you know?
Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. How's everyone going? Welcome to Chris Pollard Live. Where's everyone going? There was The Garden by PJ Harvey. Lovely little slice of 90s alternative goodness. And oh my goodness, we've only got half an hour left, which is really sad, but it's also really, really exciting because soon it's Alex Sweeney's turn to keep you entertained. And I'm going to be listening in the bath. It's time now for just a little quick perusal, if it's okay with you, at some of the things that we're going to be enjoying on the film and TV. One of the things that I've got on Series Link. I think we should call this segment Series Link. Yeah, Series Link. This is stuff that should be decided before the show. We're on this week on Series Link, How I Made My Millions. A heartfelt look into the business practices of Ernest Wrongknocker, the chemist behind Britain's number one hemorrhoid ointment. Also on tonight, Eric Idle presents A Guide to Four-Lettered Names, also featuring Mike Reed, Lady Gaga, and Pete Urquhart. I can't think of a third one. Also, I am personally all over Alan Brazil finally dipping his toe into his namesake with my first Brazilian wax, which does prove to be, frankly, chilling viewing. Also on at some point over the weekend, I'm not sure what day, Princess Margaret is hosting her favourite goalkeeping gaffes and mistakes on the Overtly Welsh network. But the star pick of the pack for me comes tonight at midnight on Bravo. Teleshopping. Just teleshopping. Love being scammed via a public broadcast. Which leads me on to say, not incidentally, those who are yet to donate to the St. Christopher's Church for the recreational biscuit consumption, I have mailed out a final notice letter for these donations as the children unfortunately grow more and more dead as the days go by. Please think of God at this time. Please think of God at this time. Please think of God at this time. But what I am willing to do for you, the good people of County Durham, is to swing open the door to the chamber of shame. You can hear me click, can't you? In the chamber of shame tonight, quadratic equations, never liked them at school. Pombear crisps, grow up! Also entering the chamber of shame, anyone who doesn't stick around tonight for both the Soul Cellar with Alex Sweeney and Hot and Cool with Chris Coxon, Durham and Air's hottest and coolest DJ, puts £10 note into pocket. Oh, I'm not supposed to say that. I'm supposed to type. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. So someone please help me out. Ah, David Lynch is here to help me out.
Let me tell y'all a story.
Chris Pollard Live. This is the sound of the future. This is the revolution. This is the manner.
Welcome back to Chris Pollard Live. You've just heard David Lynch. Yeah, David Lynch. With Star Dream Girl. Proper foot stomper, yeehaw! I was off to the farmer's market with that one. But on a more serious note, we do have to get through one more slightly more pressing matter than farmer's markets here tonight on Chris Pollard Live. And that is a trip to the Live Active Crime Association, or LACA. So let's go over to those now to read their most recent bulletin. Bulletin. Police and local archaeologists are warning all residents to be aware and wary of notorious scarf puller Estelle Ramsbottom. This crook has no regard for social distancing in a post-COVID society and has not only been filmed pulling the scarves of passing pedestrians, but sketched by local caricature artists also. If you make the conscious decision to wear a long flowing scarf on your daily commute, heed this warning. This woman is relentless in her quest to make all scarves a bit tighter, some of which have been reportedly so tight they've caused the skin underneath to go a bit red. Shocking stuff, people. If this animal gets spotted in public, the council has provided free tranquilizer darts and a 5-foot blowpipe to bring this cowardly miscreant to justice. County Durham, do your bit, blow a dart, or have your county pulled apart by Estelle Ramsbottom. Shouldn't have said it. Here's the only ones with Another Girl, Another Planet. I'll be back soon with Disney music.
Another planet.
You just gotta fall in love again.
On Durham On Air.
Hello.
there was another girl, another planet, and onto another planet I must depart. For now at least, but I will be back on Wednesday, next Wednesday, Wednesday at 7 p.m. But it's time now to kick things into a more soulful gear down in that soul cellar with Alex Sweeney. Oh yes. And then later on tonight, we have Hot and Cool with Chris Coxon. Say it at home with me. Great shows, great entertainment for you all night. Thanks for putting up with my stuff in the meantime. Whatever you do for the rest of the week and the weekend is entirely your business, but have fun while you're doing it, yeah? Take care. And goodbye.